Hello from the beautiful capital of Sri Lanka. Now, as you can hear, I've got popular bands here in the corner. I've got cricket behind me and it's absolutely electric. But this is not the reason why I'm here. I'm actually here to talk to somebody who has taken this tiny island nation to the world. She is Shashikala Siriwardena, the only woman cricketer to take 100 plus wickets and to score 2,000 plus runs for women's cricket for Sri Lanka. She's had an amazing career and she has just announced her retirement from international cricket. So I'm here today to talk to her about her brilliance on the field and of course what she has planned for the future. Shashikala, first of all, thank you so much for giving me the opportunity and for being here. I know you're really busy. I want to start from scratch. Tell me about your childhood and your family.
When I was young, in my family, my father, mother, elder brother and younger sister, five of us were the house, and I started playing cricket when I was 9-10 years with my brother. Like gully cricket,
right?
And we were living very happily. And my brother is a very sports person, so that's why I'm into sports.
So Sri Lanka women's team made their international debut in 1997. You have represented Sri Lanka for 17 years. I know the road to getting to where you are today could not have been easy. What were some of your struggles?
Yeah, I think I made my debut in 2003. Till that, I think lots of seniors, they had sacrificed lots of things more than me, I think. I have never said this to anyone, that when I come into the team, we didn't have that much of officials in the team. That is only one woman running the Sri Lanka Women's Cricket Association, because we are not involved with Sri Lanka Cricket or ICC at that time. It's a separate thing. We got involved with Sri Lanka cricket in 2006. Till that, Mrs. Gwenherath and her few, two, three officials that really dedicated to this. And at that time, Singer also helped us as a team sponsor, but no one else. When I come into the team, we never had allowances, money into this. We just only got 2,000 rupees per month for the bus fare, I think.
Right.
Also, when we are touring, we never got per diems or money, anything. Mrs. Gwenherath just managed to give 10,000 rupees per player for a tour. Okay. And I can clearly remember when we do our physical training and other things, we didn't have physios, trainers. There's my first captain, Sudarshan Shivananthan. She was the trainer and everything. We just used to go to course cricket ground on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And we just ran 15 rounds there and 1,000 abs. Yeah. So that kind of atmosphere was there, but we were really happy because we were only playing for the passion, to wear the jersey, to represent the country. So it was tough, but I think we really enjoyed it.
And so obviously it was not a career choice, it was more of a passion.
Yes.
It was a hobby, yes, which turned into a career later on.
Yes, I'm sure there were lots of talented players like me who missed because of that, because some parents can't afford it.
Yeah.
So some talented players might given up at that stage and maybe chosen another career.
Yes.
So luckily I had a very good family which was supporting me tremendously.
Shashikala, I watched your final on-field interview after the match against Bangladesh in the T20 World Cup, and you were teary-eyed. I can understand, because it was a very emotional day for you. And when asked about your career and your success, you dedicated your career to your father, amongst others. What would this have meant to him, and what role did your father play in your success?
I think totally he dedicated lots of things for me. He was taking me to practices when I was 12 years to Mr. Paltha Gunasekar. He was the first coach when I started playing hardball cricket. Right. So I was the first student of the Paling Sports Club, and my father used to take me there every Sunday. When I was going there, it's like 5:30, 6 a.m. And he was took me by the bike, and I was very sleepy. So I was like failing, and he was very afraid. And he just reconstructed the bike. He's a He's a workshop owner.
Okay.
And he used to work in ships also. He's a very good mechanic person.
Okay.
And he just reconstruct the bike. Like I can stay very comfortably with my bag, and he used to give me fork and spoon, my lunch box. So I have to go like this and take it. So he's like that. Okay. He just don't want me to, like, I can't do this, Tate, I'm tired and all that. He just can't, didn't want to hear that from me.
Yeah.
So he was trying to always keep me in a comfortable zone, and just I have to focus on playing cricket.
Yeah.
And there's a saying that if we wash our clothes with this detergent, we just get soft our palms. So, so he used to wash my clothes, even the cricket clothes.
Oh.
So he's like that. So then I can feel well with the rough palm.
Oh my
so
gosh, okay.
To that extent, he was thinking about me. So that's why I wanted to dedicate my entire career to him. And till I get married, when I was 28 years old, he used to come to every practice session, every match till I was 27 years.
Okay.
Starting from 12 years old, then till 27 years he was behind me. He just put away his work and everything, and he was coming to the ground and watching me every single minute, second, hour.
Yeah.
So he was like that, and I think I made him proud when he was alive. He just passed away in 2016, which was a very tough year for me.
Yeah.
I had lots of injuries. It was a very bad year for me. So at that time he passed away, and sometimes I feel that he would never see me retiring from cricket, because that much he loves me playing.
To see you play.
So that's why I dedicated my entire career to him.
We all set goals for ourselves. It can be personal, it can be career. You haven't just played the game, you have absolutely dominated it. And in 2014, you were ranked the world's top women's all-rounder for T20 cricket. Was that a part any of your goals, or did you even dream of such a ranking?
No, actually, I never had dreams. I had dreams, but not becoming number one personally or something. Most of the time, I have captained the team, so I had my main goal was always to be in World Cup finals or rank in like the team, ranked in number one, two, three, or maybe four. That was my dream. So I was working towards that dream, not only for me, with my other girls also, because I was the captain, so I have to make others perform and make sure the team wins. So that is the only goal I had, and later on I came to know that I have performed that much to become the number one T20 all-rounder at that particular moment in 2014 after the T20 World Cup. They released the ICC rankings and I was the number one. With me, I must mention Udeshika Prabodhini. She, both of us ranked number one. She was the bowling, from the bowling ranking, she was the number one, and I was the number one all round. So it's a huge honor and proud moment for the team. So I must say I had never dreamed about becoming number one as a player, but for the team I had that dream. I think if we work towards the victory of our team, or make sure that we are playing for that moment for the sake of our team's victory, the personal achievements will come automatically. That's why I believe.
Yeah.
So that what's happening with me at that time, that I could be the number one.
Shashikala, we've spoke a lot about your career. I just want to get to know you personally a little bit. So if it wasn't cricket, other than cricket, what other hobbies do you have?
I love watching Hindi movies, Bollywood movies, and listening songs, and spend time with my friends and family.
Okay. Are you a good dancer?
No, absolutely not.
Okay. And food, what's your favorite food?
Anything fried, which is not good for me, but I really like mixed fried rice.
Okay. So we know your brilliance on the field. Would you say you're as good in the kitchen?
I'm not that brilliant, but I think I can manage a few foods that I can make well.
Okay.
And my husband has admired me. I don't know if it's true or false, but I think I can manage a meal.
Yeah. Okay. You'll live.
Yeah.
You won't go hungry.
Yeah.
Okay, that's good. And what would you say is your favorite band? It can be local or international.
It's no particular band, but I love to listen 80s, 90s singly songs.
Yes. Oh, they are the best.
Yes.
Yeah. a time like that will never come again.
Yes.
Yeah.
I love it.
You've just announced your retirement from international cricket. In what capacity are we going to see you next?
Actually, I retired because I have to give some space to my personal life mainly. But I have done level one exams in coaching.
Okay.
And I have been coaching. I have been involved with MC Cricket Academy since last 4-5 years.
Right.
I am coaching little girls, and I really enjoyed it. I think I don't know which area will I choose, but I'm hoping to continue my work in Sri Lanka Navy, which I work currently, and that is my club for last 9 years. Hopefully I will be getting involved with lots of qualifications, because to give some service we have to be really qualified.
Right.
It's not that every player can't coach, so you can be a very good player, but you might not be a good coach.
Good coach, yeah.
So I have to, you know, think about that, and definitely my husband will help on that, because he's been coaching, he has 20 years of coaching experience.
Yeah.
I think I might go in that area, but we'll see. I try to give my service in somehow for women's cricket in Sri Lanka.
Because as selfish as I'm sounding right now, we can't let you go right away. we need to see you a little bit more. So another topic I wanted to touch on is being Sri Lankan, growing up in Sri Lanka. You know, most of the time, we don't really have a lot of choices, as in our parents would make, whether it's a career that you're supposed to choose, they would tell you what you're supposed to do. And this is just how it is in Sri Lanka. Even another thing is that when you get married, you are expected to kind of leave your career behind, or if it's a job, you know. What, as a person who has taken this tiny island nation to the world, what are your views on the topic?
Yeah, it is there, still there, and when I played, it happened. Same thing happened, but I think my father and mother, the father was, you know, leading me to this field, and with that, my brother, he was the one who taught me for the first time to how to hold the bat and how to play the forward defense. I think that's why I feel I'm very lucky that. For a girl, for a woman, I think in every step they need some kind of help from their
guidance,
family
yes.
to achieve big. That's what I've been believing. So I think anytime when I go out and speak to parents and girls, players, that I'm always mentioning this, that you need help, and parents have that responsibility to believe and to see the talent that their daughters, especially daughters, because every mother and father, they want their son to play cricket.
Yes.
But not the daughter.
Yeah.
So I think they have to be very acknowledgeable what's happening outside, and it has become a career now. It's semi-professional in Sri Lanka. Financial security is there.
Yeah.
So parents should definitely know these things and make sure if their daughter is talented, they should help.
Yeah.
At one point, the daughter, I mean the player, might choose a different thing.
Yes.
But till that, parents and if they're brothers, they can support, especially in Asia family.
And I think you're extremely lucky, because growing up you had your brother and your father to support you, and then from that your husband, who has been very supportive of your career.
Yes.
So you had a very strong support system all the way through.
Yeah. Yes. From the male side, I have got enough of support, and I must say that my mother and sister, they are very behind the scene.
Okay.
That my mother always, you know, pray for me, worshipping, taking me to temple.
Yeah.
And my sister, she's the one, you know, I think her best friend is me, and my best friend is my sister, which never happens often.
Yes.
She always, you know, want me to be where she never can achieve, but she's happy same as she's there.
In terms of the women's team, Sri Lanka women's team, what do you think we can do better, or what would you like to see changed to uplift the game of cricket for women?
I think Sri Lanka cricket has taken lots of actions over that, but still I feel that we should play more and more matches. And in school structure, we should start under 13, 15, 17 levels. Then right. At the moment, we are playing only in under 19 tournaments. Okay. But I think it's better to have on those categories which will produce more and more cricketers. And when they become 19, 20, they will be mature like men's players. Yeah. Because when we started playing cricket when we are 19 or 18, when we are mature, we'll be 28, 29.
Right.
So then once you are matured, we just can play only 2-3 years, and you know, women, they give up cricket, they focusing on marriage.
Yes.
And we might lose that brilliant player when they are becoming 32 or 33.
Yeah.
So instead of that, if we can play when we are very young, we can be mature when we are 25, 23, which will really help to do well as a team when we are coming to the national team.
Yeah.
So I would like to suggest that we have to start playing cricket when we are very young, like Australia, England, India.
Yes.
India. Yeah. They have very good structures like that.
Right.
So I think we should apply those things in our school cricket structure for girls. Our girls should play more and more cricket. But ICC have a good concept of ICC championship, which really make us to play with each and every team within 3 years. We have to play all the best 8 teams in the
okay.
world.
Okay.
So with that, I think we have improved a lot.
Okay.
And hopefully Sri Lanka cricket will try to arrange other tournaments except playing the ICC tournaments.
Yeah.
And also I think it's better to play test cricket also.
Yeah.
So those are the things which we can improve our cricket as Sri Lankans.
And hopefully we'll see all these changes that you've just mentioned. Hopefully we'll see them in the future. I know I've taken too much of your time, but before I go, and this is a question I normally ask everyone I interview, what would you say that lots of little girls and boys watching this program and obviously look up to you, what would be advice that you would give them, or words of wisdom, if you will?
I think whatever you do, you should have passion on it and believe that it is possible, and you have to dream on that. And also you need a lot of commitment and discipline. And finally, whatever you do, you have to enjoy. Happiness should in that whatever
yeah.
we do. So that is what I believe in. And at some point we need support, we need help, but mainly it's what we think about what we do. And the belief that whatever we do, we have to do with the belief. So I think keep the passion, and other things will come automatically. It's I'm just not anytime I don't like to focus on money or other things.
Right.
Only whatever you do, do it more than 100%, and other things will follow you.
Shashikala, thank you for taking the time, and I would like to congratulate you again on a brilliant career. You have been amazing. You have taken this tiny country to the world, and you've been a really, really good ambassador, very especially to women. So thank you and congratulations, and hoping you nothing but the very best. But at the same time, hopefully we'll see you soon.
Thank you. Thank you so much.